Hey church, let's do a devotional. And I want to do a devotional on the theme of having a heart of thanksgiving. It's very appropriate for us to have a heart of thanksgiving. Although this is one of the crazy, well, I can't say this is one of the craziest times I can ever remember. This is the craziest Thanksgiving. I've never, ever had a Thanksgiving like this one. But nevertheless, it causes us to step back a moment to think about what it means to be thankful. Because really, that is one of the themes of the Bible. To be thankful, even in spite of all the troubles and difficulties of life, to have an attitude of being thankful is really one of the aspects of mature spiritual faith. And I was thinking, you know, we've been recently in the book of Deuteronomy, and in Deuteronomy 32, Moses is giving this great speech to Israel to prepare them to cross the Jordan and enter into that land that God promised them. But chapter 32 is like really a keystone to the whole speech. And there's several great parts to it. You got to read the whole chapter. But I wanted to just read just a couple of verses in Deuteronomy 32 where he's talking about all that God has done for Israel. And then he says in verse 6, "Do you thus repay the Lord?" In other words, is this how you thank God? Is this how you repay God? "Is he not your father who has bought you? Is it not he who established you? Remember the days of old." Remember all the days. Consider the years. Ask your father, he will inform you. Ask your elders, they will tell you. And then he goes on and on to describe all that God has done for Israel. And really, that's our question also. Like, how do we repay the Lord for all that he has done? Well, one of the ways that you repay the Lord is by being thankful for all that he has done. You know, in the Old Testament times, of course, they had different offerings they brought to the Lord. Well, one of those offerings they brought was a thanksgiving offering. This is one that you would just simply bring because you wanted to let the Lord know that you were thankful for all that he has done in your life. And so they had a thanksgiving offering. And I just think that we should recognize that when you have an attitude of the heart which says, "God, I am so thankful. You have done so much for me, even in spite of I can see all of the troubles that we're having in this 2020 year of pandemic, and yet, God, in the midst of this crazy year, we do have so much to be thankful for." And so it's right and good for us to recognize that we give a sacrifice of thanksgiving when we come to the Lord with the right heart. When we say, "God, I'm so thankful." And I can tell you from my perspective, I have much to be thankful for. And I'll tell you one of the things I'm very thankful for, it's you. We are so blessed by an amazing church. And I just want to say how thankful I am to you. This is an amazing, amazing church. And what a privilege it is for me to be pastor here. And I just want to say from my heart how much I love you, how much I thank God for you. We stand together in this. It's meant so much to me that we could stand together in this crazy year. And just to know that we are standing together and in unity and strength, it's just been so amazing. What an encouragement to my heart. I want to say thank you from the depths of my heart. I want to say thank you to every one of you for standing with us, being the church that God has called you to be, and for having a heart and desire after the things of God. That is a huge blessing. I just want to say thank you for it. Let's pray. Father, thank you. As we come in prayer, we thank you for all that you have done. We stand in awe of you and we honor you for all that you're doing. God, thank you for blessing our lives the way you've blessed us. We truly honor you now. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen, church. God bless you.